Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.
So did you just pick up a Samsung Galaxy S9 in the shiny new lilac or coral blue or midnight black, whatever your tastes are, and you want to know, this is my first time to a Samsung, or you've had one in the past and you just want to know, I want to make sure this thing runs fast for a long time. I just paid $800 for this phone. So we're going to figure out how to do this here. And the goal by the end of this video is that you have your S9 running efficiently for the duration of your use while you do use this device. So I have 10 tips to share with you here. But before we do that, I want to clarify, when I say beast mode, what I mean is keeping the device running as fast as possible. All right, guys. So the first thing we're going to do is tweak the animations. Now, this is something that I do on every single Android device that I ever get. So let's go into settings here. We're going to scroll all the way down until we get to about phone. When we get there, let's go ahead and hit software information, locate your build number, click that multiple times until you enable developer options. When you do, hit your back button, go down into the settings menu in developer options, and scroll down until you find animations. They should say 1x, 1x, 1x right here. Window animation scale, animator duration scale, and simulate secondary, well, not that one, but the transition ones. So let's go ahead and just hit 0.5 on all of these. Now, what this does is make the animations still show, but makes them a little bit faster, making this phone more of a beast. Now, if you do put it on 0, then you're gonna turn off animations altogether, but that's kind of extreme because what it does is it kind of makes the pretty animation just look very clunky and choppy. So I'd recommend 0.5 for faster than it comes out of the box, but still gives you that nice animation look. So that's the first tip. All right, so number 2 is to disable Bixby from your home screen. So we're just gonna swipe over to the left and you're gonna see there is Bixby, but how do we disable this? So let's go home and you can see just what it does. You can't even swipe back. Then you go over here. There's always just a slight chop when you go to Bixby on the home screen. You're gonna be accidentally enabling this throughout your use. Sometimes you're gonna open up your phone and you're just gonna be swiping, it's just gonna accidentally enable and it's just gonna annoy you. So what you wanna do is pinch in, go over to the left and just turn off the Bixby button. Now, if you wanna take this a step further within the Bixby, go into your Bixby, hit the 3-dot menu up at the top and you could turn off the button which will enable Bixby from that button. So that's a bonus tip there, but disable Bixby from your home screen is at number 2. Let's get on to number 3. Okay, so this next one is to disable the one-handed mode. So how do we do this? Let's go into settings here and let's just type in up at the top search bar, one-handed mode. You can see I already typed for it to make sure it was there. And then we click it and then you turn this off. Now it is off by default, but if you turned it on, turn this feature off. I mean, unless you really are gonna use this all the time, this will slow down the launch to back to home on your device over time. So when you have that on, because Samsung is trying to recognize whether you are trying to do one-handed mode or just go home, it slows down the speed to the home screen when you do that. You see, it was just slightly faster when I turned it off. So go ahead and turn off one-handed mode if you want this phone to act more like a beast. So number 4 is a static wallpaper. So what is a static wallpaper? It's just a wallpaper that doesn't do any animations, video, or anything like that. And you can actually make a video wallpaper on this device. So get one of the static wallpapers with no motion as well as no liveness. So if you can download a live wallpaper on the Play Store if that's your thing, but those live wallpapers will slow down performance a little bit. So I do recommend that you have a static wallpaper. You could turn off the motion effect as well. This is just gonna make the resources, you know, being less used on the home screen, making it a little bit faster. So I recommend that at number 4. All right, so number 5 is to stick to the high quality apps that are well known and well rated in the Play Store. Now, in the past, you know, I had issues where some apps would actually slow down the performance of my prior Samsungs, and I don't want this to happen for you. So at number 5, just make sure that when you're downloading these apps, you take a good look at the ratings and make sure that they're high quality apps, because if they're not, they will cause some RAM management issues as well as some buildup in the resources in the background and slow down your Galaxy. It's happened multiple times on multiple Galaxies I've had. So just be aware of that and that'll keep it running like a beast. And number 6 is to keep apps to a minimum on the home screen here. Now with the Snapdragon 845, this probably wouldn't be too much of a problem, but if you start having a bunch of widgets, apps, 7 pages full of stuff, you know, and then you start building up cache in the background on a bunch of applications throughout the use of your phone, it is going to start to redraw after a long period of time. So I would say keep that home screen clean and this device is going to run super snappy each and every day for you. And number 7, do not download these antivirus software. AVG has 100 million downloads, which is ridiculous because most people don't even know you do not need these on an Android device. You can just encrypt the device, stay off of fishy websites, and you're going to be just fine. I really do not recommend downloading these on your device. You also have this phone secured by Knox. So this is not necessary to download these. And I would say that if you do download these, it might slow down your phone just a little bit because it's always going to be scanning for stuff that's going on with the device, when really most things on Android are pretty secure as long as you're not downloading it from third-party websites or you're downloading a fishy app, which you should be able to recognize just by reading the ratings. Most users will point out when somebody is putting out a fishy app, so it's pretty obvious. So this is not necessary. Do not install an antivirus software. And number 8 on how to activate beast mode is to make sure that you are rocking out with a very high quality micro SD card. If you are using external storage, this is a Samsung unit right here. Don't be fooled. Make sure you're getting a genuine one. People sell a lot of fakes of these on eBay and Amazon, so make sure you're getting the correct model before you buy one. And this should keep your phone running like a beast because slower SD cards actually slow down the camera performance and the device's loading time of storage and things like that. So I would definitely recommend getting a high quality SD card for your Galaxy S9 to keep it running like a beast. At number 9 is Edge Panel device maintenance. So when you go to the Edge, this is not enabled by default. You're going to want to go into the Edge settings and scroll over until we can find device maintenance. So it should be right here. We're going to turn that feature on, go home, go back to the Edge panel, and then just fix this, hit this fix now button every once in a while. Basically what it does is optimize device for best performance. So go ahead and do that once in a while and it'll keep your device running pretty snappy. Okay, so let's clean up some memory on the Galaxy S9. So we're gonna go into settings, and I recommend you do this at least once per week. Let's go into device maintenance and hit memory. When we get there, you can see that there's gonna be applications using up memory in the background. Android runs apps in the background. It's just how it works. And we're gonna hit clean now. When you clean now, it's gonna clean a bunch of stuff in the background. And I recommend you do this at least once per week. You don't have to incessantly do this every day, but over time, this is gonna build up and build up, and you're definitely gonna wanna clean this. As a bonus tip, I would recommend that you go back and go to the application section right here. And if you know that you're using particular apps quite a bit, for example, I use Allo quite a bit. I'm gonna go into Allo, then I'm gonna scroll down until I find storage. When I get into storage, I'm gonna go ahead and clear the cache. Now don't clear data, because data is gonna go ahead and clear everything, your sign in and all that. Just clear the cache. Now you can go through some of your applications and do that. And I think there's some apps that can, like, you know, in the App Store that will, or the Play Store that will just literally help you clear the cache a lot easier than doing it this way. But if you wanna do it manually, just do this and go into the applications that you use the most, and then go again into their storage and just clear their cache. Do that maintenance once a week and you're gonna have no issues with the Galaxy S9. And one last tip I would recommend is to lower the resolution. I know a lot of people are gonna be anxious to turn on that 2K like I did, but if you go to Full HD Plus, you will get better performance out of the Galaxy S9. Less resolution takes less power for the device to run. So definitely gonna wanna lower that resolution down to Full HD Plus. But at the same time, if you leave it at QHD and you use all the other tips, it still should be okay. So that's just like an extra cherry on top if you want the ultimate beast mode. So that's how you activate beast mode on the Galaxy S9. Remember, that means to make it as fast as possible. And I think if you do all these tips, you're not gonna have any issues throughout your use of this device with speed and lag and stuff like that. I've done this on the Galaxy S8, the Note 8, and they've run fantastic since the time I have had them. And a lot of people are gonna say, well, why would you do a lot of these things? You know, you're disabling features, things that make this device even more enjoyable to use, like the one-handed mode, for example. I wanna run the Bixby setting. I like that new assistant, or the static wallpaper. I really wanna run a live wallpaper. Well, you can do all these things, but just remember that you're gonna be using more resources and the phone's not gonna run its maximum potential. And the Snapdragon 845 and 4 gigs of RAM is already powerful enough, but these tips will just make the phone more efficient. So if you found this video helpful, enjoyable, entertaining, informing, do me a favor, click that like button for me. And if you haven't already subscribed, you might want to stay subscribed for the full review of the S9. I'll catch you on the next one. Thank you very much.